morning, children. Welcome to session 18. In last session, we discussed about land, water, how it relates to the climate, right? Now, we discuss about the winter season and what is advanced monsoon, okay? Now, just we discuss briefly about season, winter, okay? We have given this simple sentence that the temperature in the Indian landmass considerably reduces from mid-November and this cold season continues till February. Yes, obviously the winter season would be from mid of November to till February end, it will be continuous. And January is usually the coldest month. Temperature sometimes drops below 10 degrees. Yes, generally we see right. January will be the coldest month, which is the temperature around below means and a 10% degree Celsius ki takku untundi in several parts of the country. However, the cold weather is more pronounced in the northern India. Yes, northern India side cold weather chala untundi. And South India side, especially the coastal areas, enjoy a moderate climate as temperature remains well above 20 degrees Celsius. South India side, the coldest temperature will be more than 20 degrees Celsius. North side, it is below 10 degrees. And South India side, it will be 20 degrees Celsius above. And 20 degrees Celsius kanna ekku untundam. During winter, the weather is generally pleasant with clear sky, low humidity and cool breeze. Yes, winter time ela untundamma, obviously bayata climate anta kuda chala ga untundi. Sky will be clear without any clouds, right, without any rains. And humidity also very low. Humidity ante baga ukkapothama, ukkapothantaru kada, very humidity is very low. Now we are in winter season. Ippudu manam unnadi kuda winter season lo ante manaki chali ekkuva untundi. There will be no much humidity ante ukkapotha gaani vedi gaani takkuva untundi. Cyclone depressions coming from Mediterranean Sea called western disturbances cause low to moderate rainfall over North India. Yes, cyclones are maybe through Mediterranean Sea is called as western disturbances cause low moderate rainfall from North India. And then cyclones are maybe how it will disturb, you know, from our Mediterranean Sea side, and it will disturb by causing the rains. And the cyclones cause out of the cyclone episode chapter. Anytime we can get the cyclones because of climate changes, and it will disturb the northern India. This rainfall is a boon to wheat crop, which is generally cultivated in rabi season. And these cyclones for the north India side, we are cyclones for the rain. Rain will come to our crop, I mean wheat crop, which is cultivated in rabi season. Wheat crop, which is cultivated in rabi season. And then, when we see the rains more in the villages, who will be the loser finally? The farmer. The farmer will lose out because of the cultivation what he did. Because of rainfall, all the agriculture lands will be into the water, right? India lies in the trade by wind belt of northern hemisphere. Yes, India is in between the trade wind of our northern hemisphere. And the northern hemisphere side, the India trade wind will be situated. Guys, I will show you the maps and everything once we complete the climate of India chapter. This chapter I will show you maps. Okay? Northeast trades blow over India from land to sea, and therefore dry. Yes, north Indian side hemisphere flow through, there will be dry land. However, some amount of rainfall occurs on the Coromandel coast of Tamil Nadu from these winds. వీటి వల్ల ఏం చేసమ్మా కోరమండల్ కోస్ట్ కోరమండల్ కోస్ట్ దిస్ సైడ్ ఆల్సో ద విండ్స్ ఎఫెక్ట్ విల్ బి మోర్ అండ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ రెయిన్ఫాల్ రెయిన్ఫాల్ వల్ల ఈ కోరమండల్ కోస్ట్ కూడా ఎఫెక్ట్ అవుతాయి అన్నమాట right and this will be even a more problem for Coromandel coast as well which is in Tamil Nadu right Coromandel coast is ekkada undu manaki Tamil Nadu side as they pick from moisture from the Bay of Bengal while crossing it how these rainfalls comes you know from a Bay of Bengal Bay of Bengal అంటే మనం చాలా సార్లు వింటాము న్యూస్ లో కూడా Bay of Bengal it will cross the rain will cross this Bay of Bengal and the winds will flow to Coromandel coast here we have given two India maps okay if you observe I'll send these maps also right in your assignment you try to draw these two it will show the how the latitude and the range will flow from one place to one place idi anta ga draw cheyalsa pan ledu amma okay you write the points in assignment if you have time draw the maps summer now if we go to summer how it will be during hot season as we move from southern to northern part of the country yes during the hot season we move from southern to northern part of India and the average temperature increases ante ikkada ee winter season nunchi manamu summer ki move ayinappudu obviously hot I mean the humidity levels will be increased ante baaga okka pota veyadam right veediga undadam right enda baaga kottadam alantavanni increase avuthu undayam because of climatic changes starting in April the temperature rises and slowly the maximum day temperature exceeds 37 degrees celsius in northern plains of India chudandi April lo manaki summer ante winter start avutundi adu em avutundi aa temperature anedi 37 degrees nundi start avutundi we have seen 40-45 degrees also in India right like last summer we have seen more than 45 degrees celsius ante more than 45 degrees celsius ante chudandi when we go out within seconds your body will get heat ante mana body aa vediki takkoledu by mid may ante may month middle ki vachesariki how the temperature will be the temperature during the mid may touch 41 degrees celsius to 42 degrees celsius amma it's very dangerous again andike manaki summer lo schools gaani college gaani anni holidays petti and your parents will not allow you to go out in the summer season because of this is a hot ee hot ee very ee heat ki manam baidi vellalemu in many parts of the country not only in Hyderabad everywhere especially in the northern plains and central India even the minimum temperature does not go below 20 degrees celsius konni areas lo below 20 degrees kuda velladanna it will be more the northern plain experiences dry and not winds called loop winds called as loop antam winds అటని వి విల్ కాల్ అస్ లూ ఎల్ ఓ ఓ టువర్డ్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది సమ్మర్ సీజన్ ప్రీ మాన్సూన్ షవర్స్ బస్టింగ్ మాన్సూన్ ఆర్ కామన్ ఇన్ ద డెక్కన్ ప్లాట్ ఓకే ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది సమ్మర్ సీజన్ ద ప్రీ మాన్సూన్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ సమ్ వర్షాలు ఎండాకాలంలో మనం అప్పుడు వర్షాలు చూస్తాం దిస్ హెల్ప్ ఇన్ ది ఎర్లియర్ రిపేరింగ్ ఆఫ్ మ్యాంగోస్ అండ్ అదర్ ప్లాంటేషన్ క్రాప్స్ ఇన్ పెనిన్సులర్ ఇండియా అంటే పెనిన్సులర్ ఇండియాలో మనకి ఎండాకాలంలో కదమ్మా బాగా మామిడికాయలు ఐ మీన్ మ్యాంగోస్ వీ కెన్ సీ ఆన్ ద ట్రీస్ దట్ ఇస్ ద సీజన్ ఫర్ మ్యాంగోస్ అండ్ అదర్ ప్లాంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ క్రాప్స్ అంటే ఎండాకాలంలోనే మనము ఏమైనా కొన్ని క్రాప్స్ ని అగ్రికల్చర్ చేయడానికి కూడా దట్స్ అ గుడ్ టైం Hence, they are locally known as mango showers in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. See, generally we call it as mango shower. Mango shower, which we call in TS and AP, especially AP and Telangana. Mango shower, monsoon and Dhamma. At that time, we have mangoes are available. That is summer. Advanced monsoon or advancing monsoon, what is the feature? The climate of India is strongly influenced by the monsoon winds. And there are many of the Indian climate which is depends on winds and their cyclones. What is the dependent on the climate and change of the. The sailors who came to India during olden days noticed the regular periodic reversal of winds. The sailors or the people who traveled through the seas, they identified that or noticed regular periodic several winds, reversal winds. Eppudaina vastu anedi vallu kontha identify chesaru ante those who travel in the seaways. They used these windows, sorry, they used these winds to sail towards the Indian coast. Several winds pass out there. They have observed one thing. What is that? Arab traders named the seasonal reversal of winds system as monsoon. And then reversal winds of reversal other they called as reversal monsoon. That is called advanced monsoon. Advancing monsoon. The monsoon forms in the tropical area approximately between 20 degrees north and 20 degrees south latitude. Let me write this. What he is saying, this monsoon, advanced monsoon is moving approximately through tropical area between 20 degrees north, 20 degrees south latitude. 20 degrees north and 20 degrees south latitude lo untunnaru. The southeast monsoon winds from the north southern hemisphere carry moisture as they flow over the Indian Ocean and towards the equatorial low pressure zones. It will flow through southern hemisphere and moisture they lay out the and it will try to form a break the coolness of atmosphere and it will change the climatic conditions. Guys, simple thing, if only ela change hote hai na through cyclones, winds and everything, based on that India's climate will be changed. Ante tappa emi in depth ga matter em undadu. It is very simple. Don't be afraid. Okay. After passing the equator, these winds deflect towards the low pressure found in the Indian subcontinent. Right. The heating of land creates low pressure on the landmass of Indian subcontinent, especially over central India and the Gangetic Plain. The climatic changes for that, especially the Indian Gangetic Plain will get more changes in a climate. Along with this, the Tibetan Plateau, Gangetic Plain, and Tibet or Tibetan Plateau, you can call Tibetan Plateau. This will be having a more changes in climate. Tibetan gets intensely heated and causes strong vertical air current and the formation of low pressure over the plateau at above 9 km latitude. 9 km latitude through the winds, heat winds are ready, heat air are ready, flow through the mouth. Flow 9 km latitude. And then we will go on to the question. The air will keep on flows from one distance to another distance. And then, if we go to the cyclone, we will go to the climate. That is the heat winds. We will go to the heat bar. That is the effect. They flow as the southern monsoon of the Indian Peninsula divides them into two branches. Indian Peninsula, two branches are divided. What is that? Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. The Bay of Bengal branch strikes the Bengal coast at the southern face of the Shillong Plateau. Bay of Bengal is the Shillong ke related. Sir, what is Shillong? Shillong Plateau. Shillong Plateau. Then it gets deflected and flows westward along the Kalahari Plain. The Arabian Sea branch arrives at the west coast of India and goes northward. Both the branches reach India by beginning of June. He went to Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea into Kuda. The climatic changes change out. It will reach out to the beginning of June. June which is the monsoon start of because of this Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea moves at one place. And then June mani ki baga rainy season ne start hoti, which is known as one set of monsoon. One set of monsoon are endika marante Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. At a time flow to climate change chestu mani ki rains ni istu. And they gradually spread over the entire country in 4 to 5 weeks. Entire country no flow to the that too 4 to 5 weeks no our climate changes are getting for and they are in 1 to 5 within 4 to 5 weeks. This bulk of annual rainfall is in India is received from southwest monsoon. Yes, the bulk of bulk in the sense heavy rains are the west south monsoon. Southwest monsoon flow. The amount of rainfall is very high along the west coast due to western Ghats and in northeast India due to high peak hills. Yes, ee rains are kuda due to high peak hills mountains evaithe undayo akka nunchi gradually ga climate change avutu rains anevi easy ga start ayyayi. Tamil Nadu coast Coromandel. Yes, Tamil Nadu coast Coromandel. However, remains mostly dry during this week as it is in the rain shadow area of Arabian Sea branch and is parallel to the Bay of Bengal branch. Yes, Coromandel. Even the Coromandel coast is having very low rains and it is in the shadow of the rain show. Arabian Sea kuda ikkada em avutundi parallel ga flow avutundi Arabian Sea kuda. Bay of Bengal branch ki is parallel ga flow to climatic conditions anedi changes. If you see I'll show you the diagram here. If you see this I'll send you this one into the book. If you see here the high pressure is in northeastern monsoon and if you see low pressure is in southwest monsoon, but this high pressure is in January and low pressure is in July. Here July it will be rainy season and if you see this January is in a winter season obviously, right? In this way the low pressure will be rains ekku untunnayi ikkada vacharki there will be no rains. This January will call as a high pressure and this July will be called as a low pressure of monsoon, advancing monsoon season here. Clear? I'll send you this peak in a class, don't worry. And in total the climatic conditions will be depends on the advanced monsoon as well. These advanced monsoon who have checked because the few sailors, the few people who passes the seas, then they identified the periodic changes and the regular simultaneous changes how to like after they have given some information about the advancing monsoon. Okay, this is your assignment. I'll send you the peaks now. Okay, peaks are here. What you want to be from this, just keep a reference for you. 5 minutes, then just go with assignment of advancing monsoon, season, winter, and summer. Write a few short points and do the assignment for a session. Okay, we'll meet in 19 session with a new topic. Okay, boys. Bye. Take care.